Hello everyone, I am Pratik from Department of Financial Studies, University of Delhi, and today we are going to discuss basic regression in EViews. So let's get started. So this is the work file on which I'll be working. We have cross-sectional data of dividend of 116 companies. So as you can see, 116 observations. So we have data with regard to amount of dividend, assets, company name, net cash flow, net profit margin, profit after tax and retention ratio. Now, other than these variables, which we have actually taken from our data file, there are two additional variables. One of them is C, which is the intercept of our regression equation. And as you can see that since we haven't run any regression so far, this entire series is empty. And the other additional variable which by default appears in the work file is resid, and resid is nothing but the residual series of any regression that we run in EViews. So this is also empty as of now because we haven't run any regression. Now running a regression in EViews is very, very easy. Let's get started. Now before you run the regression in EViews, you simply need to imagine the equation in your mind, and once you have done that, you simply go to quick, estimate equation, and this dialog box appears. And now let us start writing our variables in the order in which they appear in our equation. So let's say amount of dividend is my dependent variable, which is Y. So I write amount, and as you can see that as I write the name of a particular variable, EViews suggests me this drop down in order to select that variable. So I select amount of dividend. Now I press space. Space is used to actually differentiate, or actually to tell EViews that now we are referring to another variable. So it is a space bar represents that two variables are being separated. So I press the space bar and then I click C, which represents the constant or the intercept term in my regression model. And then I write the independent variables in my equation. So let's say I believe that net cash flows is something which determines the amount of dividend that a company declares. So I select this variable, net cash flow. Then again I hit space in order to separate this independent variable from my next independent variable. And let's say I believe that net profit margin also determines the amount of dividend. So this is my equation. Amount of dividend is the dependent variable, C is the constant, net cash flows is my first independent variable, and net profit margin is my second independent variable. So this completes my regression equation, all the variables being separated by a space bar. Now you have a lot of options with regard to the estimation methods that you can use in EViews. Each one has its own relevance. So as of now, we'll be running the most basic estimation method called least squares. So I would select that sample. As you can see, from observation 1 till 116, if you want to change your sample, then you can make the changes here. So I'll simply click OK and you get the regression output, and you can see that net cash flows is coming out to be significant as the p-value is 0, whereas net profit margin is not significant, r-square being 79%, dependent variable, as you can very well see, it is amount of dividend, c, the coefficient is also appearing, it is negative. Now since we have run the regression, let's now go to this variable called c, and you can have a look that the C, that is the intercept, is now showing us the three coefficients which we have received as output in EViews regression. So these are the three coefficients which appear in this variable called C after running the regression. And if I click on reset, this is the variable which now shows me the residual series of my regression. So as you can see, I have 116 resid values for my dependent variables, 116 values. So I close this. Now if let's say that you want to modify your regression, and let's say you want to remove net profit margin because it is not coming out to be significant, so you don't have to delete this equation. You just have to go to this button called estimate, and there is your equation which you just wrote, and you can very well remove net profit margin from here. Click OK, and net cash flow is coming out to be significant. And in fact, whenever you run regression in EViews, you can go to view representations, which actually displays the entire equation along with the coefficients which have appeared in the output. So as you can see, substituted coefficients, amount of dividend is equal to this figure, which is the intercept term plus the coefficient, the beta coefficient of net cash flows. So this is the entire equation that we have just run on EViews. Now if I again go to view estimation output, alright. Now let's say that you want to compare two models in EViews, and you want to see that which one is better. So now let's say that I want to see that if I take another variable, which is net profit margin as well, but now this time let's say I take log of both my independent variables. So as you can see that it is very easy to transform any variable in EViews within the equation itself. So for example, if you want to take log of a particular variable, you just have to write log in front of that variable, and you have to enclose that variable's name in brackets. So this is what I have done. I have taken log of both my independent variables, and now I'll click OK. And there you see the output. Again, as you can see that net cash flow is significant, whereas net profit margin is not significant. And let's say if now I want to compare this model with another model, so what I can do is that without deleting this window, I can simply freeze it, and there you see, this is the frozen window of the output which I received from EViews. Right, so this is the frozen output which I received from EViews. And now let's say that I want to make changes to my model. Let's say I want to add another variable, which may be profit after tax. Let's see. Alright, and also let me take log of this variable as well. Alright, now I click on OK, and there you see, you have now got the output of this equation as well. And what you can do is, you can compare both the equations if you want. So your dependent variable is the same, number of observations same. Here you have two variables on the independent side of the equation. Here you have three, and we can very well compare, let's say, the adjusted R square in order to see which equation is explaining more variation in the dependent variable. So the adjusted R square is high in this particular equation. So 39 against 37 here. So this is a better equation, right? So we can delete this as of now. Yes. And in fact, as an extra piece of information, you can also check the normality of any of your variables in EViews. So you can go to quick, series, statistics, histograms and stats. So let's say I want to check the normality of this variable called net cash flows, but I want to also take the log of this variable before checking its normality. So I type log bracket start net underscore cash underscore flows. So I have to now type the full name of the variable exactly in the way it appears in the work file. So I click OK, and there you see you get the histogram of this variable, and these are the descriptive statistics, the Jagbira test of normality and its respective p-value. So you can see that this variable is normally distributed because p-value is greater than 5%. So you can check the normality of any of your independent variables in this manner. And if you want to, let's say, save this output because you have to report it in a research paper or in another document, so what you can do is click anywhere on the table and press Ctrl plus A. Now just copy this entire table by pressing Ctrl plus C, and EViews asks you whether do you want to save it in full precision or in the way it appears in the table. So I say copy numbers as they appear in the table. Okay, I go to my Word document and I press Ctrl plus V. So I have pasted the entire output in this Word document. So you can very well pick the relevant variables that you want to report in your research paper. Alright, so I go to my EViews file again, and if you want to, let's say, save this, what you can do is go and simply name this equation. So let's say it is equation number 1. I don't want to change the name, so I simply click on OK, and this equation appears as another object in my work file now. So if I double click on it, the output will appear. So this is how you can save any equation in EViews as an object in your work file. Alright, so this is how easy it is to run regression in EViews. So this is it for this particular video. And before we end, closing thoughts. Attitude is a little thing that makes a big difference. So keep your attitude always positive. Nothing is difficult if you work hard and if you are determined to do it. So just be positive and be happy. This is Prateek Bedi signing off. Thank you so much for watching this video. Thanks a lot.